बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामु अलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुह। स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट लेक्चर व्हिच इज लेक्चर नंबर 3 एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग इज अबाउट पार्टिकल नेचर ऑफ मैटर। So in this chapter we will cover these points and inshallah today in our this class we will discuss about the contributions that are paid for the development of the particle theory of matter. There were different scientists who contributed for the development of the of this concept that matter is composed of particles, tiny particles. So this is also known as the particle theory of matter. So based on the evidence from observations and investigations, scientists have accepted the particle theory of matter as an explanation of the nature of matter. Many scientists at different times contributed for this purpose. So we will discuss few of them. So we start from Democritus. He was the first scientist who started his contribution from the development of this concept. So he was a Greek philosopher. He worked 460 to 370 BCE. He hypothesized that all matter is made up of tiny discrete particles called atoms, which are too small to be seen. So according to him, every matter is composed of particles, discrete. As I told you in the previous class, that the meaning of discrete is that discrete meanings it is countable in terms of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 as a whole number. It cannot be in points, okay? It cannot be 1.3 or 4.5. That's not true. It can only be counted in terms of 1, 2, 3 and 4 and hundreds and thousands and millions and trillions of particles, okay? And that particle are said as atoms. Okay, he named that particles as atoms. So, and which are too small to be seen, which cannot be seen with our eyes. So, number second who contributed for this purpose is Aristotle. Aristotle was the second scientist who contributed for this purpose and in this regard. He was a Greek philosopher. He was also a Greek philosopher. He worked during 384 to 322 BCE. According to him, he hypothesized that the matter has continuous composition that can be broken down into smaller and smaller pieces. Means he said, if suppose we take a piece of wood and we divide it into two, so it will be half, and if we divide that half further into two pieces, it will be 1/4, and if that particular 1/4 piece is divided into two pieces, it will be equal to 1/8. So according to him, according to Aristotle, he said matter is a substance which can be broken down into smaller and smaller pieces, means we can divide it into further pieces or into further parts, okay? And he also said that the matter has a continuous composition, means everywhere matter is equally distributed within that substance. So I hope that you understood this thing. Number third who comes on third is John Dalton. John Dalton was English chemist. He worked during 1766 to 1844 AD. He suggested that the matter is made up of small discrete particles. Means atom, means matter, any matter is made up of very little tiny and discrete particles, which are like little solid balls, okay? So he said, according to his concept, he said, the atoms or the particles, he did not call them atoms, but he said which are like little solid balls, okay? So number four, if we start study, number four, here Robert Brown comes. He was a Scottish scientist and he worked 1773 to 1858 AD, okay? And according to him, he observed the he observed with a microscope that pollen grains in water were moving about constantly and randomly in all directions, because he performed an experiment. What he did, I think we have discussed in the previous class, but I am taking a review. So he took water in a container, okay, and then he put some amount of pollen grains. Pollen grains are supposed to be the lightest particles, right? So he put some pollen grains into it. This blue color is showing you the amount of pollen grains. And he observed after some time that these pollen grains are started moving in random and every possible direction, and continuously they were moving. So he concluded that due to that random motion of the water particles, it was moving. So its answer was given by Albert Einstein. Albert Einstein said, he was German-born American scientist or physicist, right? And he worked during 1879 to 1955 AD. He explained that the pollen grains were moving because they were being bombarded by the moving of water particles. Bombarded by the moving water particles means water particles, as in the previous slide we talked, that water particles are moving, pollen grains are moving due to that movement of that water particles, right? So we can say that any matter or any substance is made up of small particles, okay? Any of the matter is made up of small particles. And number two, particle nature of matter is verified. We can say that the particle nature of matter means every matter is composed of particles, right? So review, we say Brownian motion. We discussed and we studied about Brownian motion in the previous lecture. Brownian motion is the random movement of a particle such as pollen grains in the liquid or gas. Diffusion is the net movement of particles from a region of higher concentration to a region of lower concentration. Diffusion means the particles spread throughout the space or throughout the region equally from the higher concentration region to a lower concentration region. We have discussed both of these things in the previous lecture. And the particle theory of matter states that the particle is made up of small discrete particles which are in constant and random motion, okay? So these concept that we have built on the basis of our previous knowledge that we have covered, inshallah. So conclusion of today's class is that we discussed about the different scientists with their brief introductions, okay? We took brief introduction of different scientists. We covered up almost five scientists, okay? And we also looked that what they have contributed for the development of this concept, matter has particle nature. So this has been proved and verified. In our next lecture, we will study about how does the particle theory explain the properties of matter and the charge and changes of a state. How does the particle theory explain the properties of matter? There are different properties of matter, there are different states of matter that we will inshallah discuss in the coming lecture. And the changes of the state, how does change of state for any matter takes place due to means we will cover it on the behalf of particle theory, right? So coming things that you have to note down is you have to complete the work of chapter number one, as I mentioned you in the previous lecture also, and your home assignment is to write down and to memorize the key points from page number 69 on your textbook. So please do this work complete and ask me any question if you have. So Jazakallah. Now we move towards our discussion session.